I'm always digging for new stuff. I go to the record store every week. But the problem is that I buy so much vinyl-only stuff, and I don't have that much time to rip them, because I don't like to take my vinyls to every gig. Some gigs here and there, but... and so I have so much cool music that it's just kind of like stacking up. And I buy mostly electro. That's what I buy on vinyl. So digging, for some reason, the electro scene is what kind of keeps me excited about music, because there's always like some cool new producer making like really cool sounds or different sounds in the glitch and electronica scene. I think in general, the scene has forgotten about futurism in music, which is important because that's how it was. That's, I believe, what the fathers of electronic music, Kraftwerk, and all the European and then the Detroit guys later, were always thinking about doing futuristic music. And that's how I got into it in the 90s. And now I think everybody's trying to make very current music, like what is the current sound that's working on the dance floor? What's the current, you know, cool tool to use in the studio or whatever? And I feel like the futurism is gone, kind of. I just like to listen to music, so I'm always buying music and checking out some new tracks. But I think there's definitely other DJs that are better at building a set, you know, over an all night long type 8 hour set and really building like this atmosphere. Most of the music I produce is just, I don't like think about it too much, and I just do it whenever I have time, because now that we have a son named Solar and like a pretty tough schedule of touring and stuff, and I barely have any time at home, I just find like 3 or 4 hours every day to work on some music. And I'm pretty fast. That's a good thing. I'm fast in the studio, but I go in, I don't have an idea, I just kind of start messing around with a synth or a new software that I got or something, and then some idea comes out. But I'm always trying to sound a little bit different than the stuff currently releasing, because it's kind of boring to sound the same. In my opinion, the passion for music is lost. The drug use is up, and so you would think the passion should be up, but passion seems to be down because there's so much big business involved. There's a big business now that used to not be such an important thing, and now everyone is trying to be the next Ritchie Houghton or the next Ben Fate. So they use a lot of PR and marketing, and they forget just, you know, that there needs to be substance. Also, most of them don't really know how to produce. So think about half, maybe more than half the scene in the moment doesn't know how to produce, doesn't even make their own music. They use producers to do the music. The scene is mostly marketing now. It's sad. It's a sad time, but at the same time, it's an exciting time, because then it gives anybody that has a little bit of talent really like blow up and show up and show off the talent, you know? The charisma and the performance aspect of DJing is really important. Especially, I remember the first real guy I saw be a big performer was Ben Fate in the 90s. And then, because, you know, I was so used to seeing Detroit guys, just they don't give a shit. They're just like looking down. And I realized with that, and maybe later with in the 2000s with Ricardo, and the way, you know, he's got this charisma behind the decks. And I realized that it's super important. I think it's more important in Europe than it was in my small town. And I mean, I call it a small town, but Dallas is a small town in Miami compared to the whole European scene. I think that it's became more important once I moved to Spain. But I'm not good at it. I'm not good at being charismatic. I just play and I look up and I smile and I go like this, but I don't really, you know, do much else. And even that is more difficult for me to do. It's very difficult for me to be a performer. I don't know why I did so well, but I think it's because maybe the timing of the productions, the timing of the DJing as well. I try to not stay the same for very long. I'm always going, trying to stay one step ahead, which is not really that far ahead. It depends on the level of underground you're looking for. Obviously, if you're super underground, then you think I'm behind. But in the grand scheme of things, and the way, say, for instance, the big clubs work, or Ibiza works, or what's going on in Berlin or London, I'm paying attention. I'm trying to move and evolve. And I think maybe that helped me to get to the point where I am, to stay at this point. But I just wish there was more like that. There was more people paying more attention to that than having the best photography at the time, the best pictures and the coolest quotes, you know. I have the same haircut. My wife is a hairstylist and she's mad at me because I've had the same haircut for at least 10 years. I am, I'm really fucking boring. I only like to make music. I don't like to go to the beach. I don't like to necessarily go looking for cool food restaurants. I just make music, that's it.